jóvenes será sumamente importante en las próximas elecciones. Tuvimos la oportunidad de platicar con Ana Paulina Luna, de origen mexicano, y quien es la congresista más joven del estado de Florida en el Congreso de los Estados Unidos.
Thank you so much for being with us. Thanks for having me. Okay. It's great to have you on Fox News. I would like to start with your impressions on the convention.
So very happy to be here. Obviously, this is my first time speaking, so pretty historical, not just for me, but I think too, what we're seeing is there's a change within the Republican Party. And so when they're showcasing newer people, especially people from my background, I think it's pretty cool.
Yes, and I wanted to address that because of course, I mean, you are Hispanic and the Hispanic community has become very important and crucial for this upcoming election.
I think for future elections too, we're the biggest voting minority.
And not only that, but we like big families. So we are the fastest growing too.
Yeah.
So yeah, you just said it right. So what will be your message for the Hispanic community, especially because they're being lied to for so many years for some media outlets that portrays Republicans as anti-immigrants, racist, you know. So what will be your message for them?
I'd say, and this is just based on what I'm seeing when I talk to people, right? A majority of Hispanic Americans are business owners. And so with this economy that we're currently seeing, you're not going to see a change unless we go back to the policies that President Trump had. You know, even just comparing 4 years ago, whether it's the price of gasoline or groceries, we had people that were able to afford things. Now, I mean, I just saw recently there was a viral story that it was, I think, a $450 tab from going to Whole Foods for a family. And so I think for us specifically talking about the economy, but then also too, you know, with illegal immigration, it hurts people that are trying to come here the correct way. And I think Vivek said it the best. He goes, you know, my parents were immigrants and they came here and they made some things for themselves. But for people that are coming here illegally, you know, they might not be all bad, but they're breaking the law. And you can't have a country that's, you know, run on people that are breaking the law. And so I agree with that sentiment. You know, it's interesting though. I am one of the youngest members of Congress on the Republican side.
Yes.
I am half Mexican. And when I first got elected, I think because of the fact that I'm able to articulate those facts and also because of my blood, I was a target for the leftist media. And so I think it was maybe only a couple weeks after I got elected, the Washington Post put out this awful, awful hit piece saying that I wasn't Hispanic enough. They kept saying that. Like, what does that mean? You know, is it supposed to be because of my skin color? They tried to stereotype Hispanics as, A, just being Mexican, which is not true. We're not just monolithic. But then also, too, skin color. I mean, that's racist. And then, obviously, that, you know, Time Magazine did a deep dive, and they named me one of the top 100 most influential people in the world because I was telling the truth. And so, you know, we have to use our voices and outlets like Vox to actually fight back against that narrative. But it's going to be interesting because I do think now you're seeing more Hispanics getting active than even a couple of years ago. And I think that that's going to be incredibly important moving forward.
Absolutely. And I have to say, I mean, you just mentioned that you're young, you're a Hispanic woman, beautiful, Mexican, I'm a Mexican too, you know. So what would be your message for people? Because sometimes we Hispanics, we have strong values. We love our families.
Yeah.
We like to work hard, and as you mentioned, a lot of us are entrepreneurs.
Business owners.
Yes. So, but a lot of them are not interested in getting involved in politics. But I think it's a mistake, especially because we are growing so fast and we really need representation. So what will be your message for
that? Everything that happens politically is going to impact your pocketbook. And so whether or not you want to get involved, you should. Otherwise, you have people that are up in Washington, and I've seen it happen. They would never spend their own money the way that they spend money here. The more that they spend in Washington, the more that inflation goes up, which means everything gets more expensive. And so just remember, even if it's at the local level, it all matters.
Finally, what are the challenges that District 13 is facing right now in Florida?
I'd say the number one issue that we're having right now is the economy. People are talking about how expensive everything is. In fact, so much so that people are actually getting forced out of Tampa Bay area and having to move because it's gotten that expensive. That in addition to we've had issues in the past with beach renourishment. So what I will say is, you know, when you have an administration, you have political appointees. And because Florida is a red state, the administration has intentionally blocked our ability with the Army Corps of Engineers to protect our beaches and to restore them. And so what I will say is that, you know, you have an administration that likes to say that they care about the environment, but if you're in a red state, they don't.
Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you,
Paulina. Great to talking to you.